Hello, friends. This is Bud Brown living in Dumaguete City, Philippines. Yeah, baby. Hey, I want to tell you a little story. It's a story of an attitude adjustment. When I first got here to the Philippines, as many of you that live here or have been here may experience, there are a few things that are different here and can be very frustrating if you don't have a good attitude. Well, when we first got here, I used the bus a lot, and I've learned a lot about the bus system. The main one here in the Visaya area, or at least in the Cebu, Negros Islands area. In Cebu Island and Negros Island, which is only places I've been, it's what they call the series bus, big yellow buses. And there's two main kinds. There's the what they call the regular, which is smaller and with smaller seats, with no air conditioning. And the aircon, which has air conditioning, bigger seats, few pesos more, but well worth it, I found out. So before I realized that it's worth it to pay a few pesos more for the aircon, I used to ride the regular buses. And they're like what we call in my hometown milk runs. In other words, they stop at every little town, whereas the aircons are kind of like express buses. They go from, you know, one point directly to the destination without stopping. I may be wrong on that, but that's the way it seemed. Well, the thing that really bothered me quite a bit was that I would get on these regular buses, and even though no one was getting on or getting off, they would stop periodically for the men to go out to the bushes and urinate. So I kind of felt sorry for the women. They seemed like they stayed in the bus, or the men went out, went alongside the road. That was always frustrating to me. Well, there was an incident that happened that gave me an attitude adjustment. Just before going on to the bus, I caught a ferry that go from Negros Island to Cebu Island, about a 20-minute ferry. And there's usually sometimes there's vendors there that sell little snacks and things. And there was a lady that sells these peanuts. I think you call them Spanish peanuts, kind of round, and they come in a little plastic tube, and real cheap, 5 pesos or 10 pesos, you know, 10 or 20 cents. And I bought one, salted. Man, they were good. I like peanuts in general. So went on the ferry, got on the aircon bus, which I was happy that it was aircon because of the bigger seats and going straight to where I was going, which was about an hour away. For those that are familiar, I was going from, what's the name of that place? I can't think of it, but anyway, where I caught the bus, where the ferry stops, and then up to Dalaguet, which is where we used to live, about an hour away. So I got the very seat, and the very first seat, and there was a lady right next to me. And we were going along, everything was good. And then pretty soon I started feeling my stomach kind of growling a little bit. I thought, uh-oh. So I thought, well, I can hold it for, you know, an hour, I think. So pretty soon, about 10 minutes later, I started getting a real urge. I had to go to the bathroom. Felt like I was getting ready to have diarrhea or something. And I looked, oh my gosh, I still got 45 minutes to go. So I thought, well, you know, I can tough it out. I've done that. I've toughed it out before, having to wait to go to the bathroom. So as we went on down the road, not stopping anywhere because it's a aircon bus, express bus, which I didn't want to get on those milk run buses, you know. So about another 10 minutes, I really felt that, man, I'm going to have to do something. I'm not going to make it an hour. So I was thinking all the options I had, and I thought, well, maybe I could just tell the guy, I need to get off here, and some reason or another, and then I'd go run out in the bushes, or kind of like a little forest there next to the road, and then I'd catch another bus, regular bus, go the rest of the way. And I thought, man, I don't know, you know, I don't have any tissue or toilet paper. So another 10 minutes went by, and it was just getting to where, I was getting almost nauseous. I thought, man, I'm not gonna make it. So I tell the lady next to me, I'm speaking English because I didn't know Tagalog or Bisaya at the time. I said, I've gotta go, I have to use the CR. It's gonna be an emergency. And so she tells the driver, brup, 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 you know, pointing to me, and I'm thinking, oh, this is embarrassing, but man, what can I do? I'm gonna have an accident here. That'll be even more embarrassing. So he says, 10 minutes, so we'll stop. Oh, so I was just, with all my strength, I was trying to hold it in, and I just, you know, I imagined this stuff backing up, and I was just starting to get nauseous. I thought I was gonna throw up, and finally he pulls over. And he pulls over at a gas station, which that's why we had to go 10 more minutes, because it was a gas station that he knew was up ahead. And then there was a restroom in there. So I was kind of half trotting to get over there, had to cross the road, then get in. And there was a lady standing in front of this bathroom. I said, man, I'm just gonna have to knock her out away or something. Well, fortunately, she was waiting for her husband. Soon as I got there, he walks out and they both walk away. I rush into the bathroom just in time. And the relief. And I just thought, this is never gonna happen again in my life. And then it kind of dawned on me that all these people in the bus who took the aircon on purpose, like me, so they would go straight through, they're all waiting for this foreigner. They're waiting for me. I tried to hurry, I couldn't hurry. And so, you know, there comes a time you just gotta let nature take its course. So I know everybody was in a hurry, they were waiting. And so finally, when I felt, you know, comfortable that, you know, I could go for another 45 minutes or an hour, I said, you know what, this is embarrassing, but I'm just gonna have to face the music. So I kind of hurried back, and I got on the bus. I told the driver, I said, I'm sorry, it's an emergency. Nah, no problem. And everybody on the bus, I said, I'm sorry. I felt I had to apologize to everybody. And everybody said, okay lang, that's okay, no problem. So I got on and we took off and I went to my destination. And that was several years ago. And do you think that since that time that I complain when the bus stops and people have to get off for some reason or another? I had an attitude adjustment, and now everything is just fine. So, you know, sometimes it takes a little bit. We learn lessons in life. Some lessons can be learned easily, and some can be learned the hard way. So my lesson from this is just be patient, don't be in a hurry, and because I know that at that time and other times, I've had to have the Filipinos be patient with me. So anyway, I wanted to share that story, and I hope you have a great day, Take care, and I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.
What's up? Attitude adjustment.